You know, Samaruzaria, not gate, ABU. That was where my house was. I will trek from ABU, not gate, to Congo campus. You know Congo? I will go to Congo campus to attend Bible teaching and trek back. And I did it not for 1 month, 3 months, 5 months, 1 year, 2 years. Rain will be falling, I'm trekking. Rain will stop, my body will dry with my clothes on. I'm not telling you a fairy tale. I will trek, and when I'm trekking, I'm singing. When I'm tired of singing, I'll be meditating on the scripture that was taught in the last Bible study. Until I get there. Sometimes we finish Bible study. You know those days of Philip Mukunga, those early days. Philip Mukunga, when they start Bible study from 6 p.m., they finish 3 a.m. I'm not joking. 3 a.m., we are still there. Then when we close, some will sleep there, but those of us that are strong will trek. I get home like sometimes 6 a.m., 6:30, I'm getting home, trekking, and I'm happy. 4 o'clock, I have left the house. I just came back 7 a.m., 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I am trekking back for the next Bible study. I'm telling you what we did. Because of passion for the word of God. Passion for the word of God. Except you are not in love with the word. I remember those days. We didn't have access to material. One day I went to one Professor Ishaya Audu's house. The wife went in and brought trunk boxes of Benny Hinn's teaching materials. Kenneth Hagin. Oh, Kenneth Copeland. See them in trunk boxes. I felt like stealing that day. I said, oh God, I wish I can just take 2 sets. Those are the days we will go to somebody's house and see a book. Can I borrow? No. We will sit down there with pen and biro and copy the book. I'm not joking. I'm not joking. It's not today's kind of Christianity that people are just doing it one kind. No. We are talking about people that are sold out. That have seen that nothing in this world can compare with eternal realities. And they are sold out to eternal realities. This passion you see in me is not today it started. It has been there. God is my witness. It was there even when I didn't have any hope that one day I will be a preacher at this level. And I didn't care whether I succeeded to be a preacher or not. All I wanted was to know God. All I wanted was to know Christ. All I wanted was to grow in the knowledge of Christ. When you see the way God is using us, the kind of investments we open up for God to make in our lives through deliberate and intentional availability, it's impossible for God not to use us. You pray for 15 minutes, you're looking for a chair to sit down. When some of us pray from 6 a.m. till the following morning, 6 a.m., non-stop, we will sweat. At the end of prayer, you would think a flood of rain fell. The whole floors are filled with water. They have to either mop it or use broom to push the water out. Sweat coming out. In Oyo here, is there any street I did not trek? There's no street I didn't trek in this town. Praying all night. Some of you know what I'm talking about. All night praying, street to street. People are sleeping, we're trekking, we're praying. Sometimes dogs will bark, we rebuke them and command them to shut up. They will sit down and keep quiet till we're gone. I'm not joking. You know, I would tell the dogs, in the name of Jesus, sit down, quiet, and I will pass. So when we are talking about demas, we are talking about ministry, we are talking about fulfilling God's purpose for your life. We're not joking. We're not joking. Good minister. Faithful minister. You know, why is it that sometimes when pressure comes and people come under pressure, the first thing they want to shade off is ministry? You understand? Pressure, work, marriage, family, everything. Say, you know, so much pressure on me. I want to withdraw my commitment in church so I can focus on the material world. The first thing you always think of when you're under pressure, the one you can give up is church. At least let me withdraw my commitment in church. Let me focus on this other one. Why should it be church first? Why is church the first one you want to withdraw from? Why? Why is it that when you are so busy, the one you give up is the kingdom? Why? When pressures come from everywhere, the only one you can give up is the kingdom. I want to withdraw so I can take care of other things. And the one you withdraw from is the one you actually need. You matter about many matters. Yet, one thing is needful, and your sister has chosen the better part that shall not be taken away from her. What is the better part? The world. Somebody was coordinating a house center. He just abandons it. Why do you abandon the flock? Because you love the present world. You're no more in love with the flock of God.